Hello everyone, in today's video, we are discussing the cost of getting your private pilot's license. Let's do it. Now before we dive right into a whole bunch of numbers with dollar signs attached to them, and believe me, there will be a few dollar signs. If you haven't seen my previous video explaining the private pilot's license process from start to finish, then I highly recommend you check it out because it'll give you a good understanding as far as what flight training is like, the process, the requirements, and what it was like for me when I did my license from start to finish. And if you want, you can also check out some of the other videos on my channel where I document my life as a pilot. And don't forget to subscribe. I really appreciate the support. All right, so to make this simple and organized, I've decided to break down the different components of the private license that we can assign a dollar figure. This will help paint a clearer picture as far as where the bulk of your money is going to be spent and when. I also decided to provide a low and high cost estimate for each part of the training. This took a little bit of research, calling individual flight training facilities, but since flight schools, colleges, flying clubs, et cetera, have different prices, this should help establish a pricing range that you can expect to fall within. Depending on what school you choose and more specifically how well you advance through your training and how efficient you are at learning will determine what your total flight training costs will be. And then at the end of this video, I'll tell you what it cost me to get my license as a comparison. Now, like I said, my other video on the private pilot's license explains all of the training components in detail. So if any of this seems unfamiliar or you're at all confused, don't worry, I've got you covered. I'll put the link to that video in the description as well as at the end of this video. Now, the first cost that you can expect to incur and what I think you should incur right off the start is an introductory flight. You want to make sure you know exactly what you're getting yourself into. 99% chance you will be hooked and want to get started right away, but it's a good idea to make sure. Budget around $150 to $300 for the introductory flight. Then there's the ground school component or the ground school course. It's either done in a classroom environment or you can do it as an online platform. I'd budget around $200 to $500 for this. I've even seen online platforms as low as $150. And of course, ground school isn't anything without supplies. You're gonna need some course materials, flight calculators, maps, pens, subscriptions to things such as flightplan.com or ForeFlight, even a knee board. There's gonna be a whole bunch of things that you're gonna need in order to do the private pilot's license ground school as well as the in-flight training. So I'd budget around $250 to $600 for the basic supplies. Now keep in mind that some flight schools will offer like a starter package or the bare minimum with the ground school or as soon as you sign up for training. So this might be incorporated in the ground school costs, but just to be on the safe side, budget around $250 to $600. Then once you're done the ground school, there's the written exam cost. Budget around $140 to $250 for this. If you fail the test, don't be intimidated if you do, but you'll have to pay that fee again. Now, before you start flight training, you are going to need an aviation medical, either a category 3 or a category 1. I recommend going for the category 1 because if you have any intentions of getting your commercial license, you are going to need a category 1 medical. And these medicals can cost anywhere from $150 to $200. The last time I renewed my category 1, it was $150. So budget anywhere $150 to $200. Keep in mind, this has to be renewed every single year if it's a category 1. If it's a category 3, it's good till 5 years, I believe. So just keep that in mind that that's a recurring cost in order to keep flying. So this leaves us with a cost so far ranging from about $890 to $1,850. A fairly large range depending on what the flight school's prices are, how much they provide as far as course materials go. Sometimes all the required supplies are provided in a flight school's starter package, like I was saying, when you sign up for ground school. Now, if you're impressed with the pricing so far, then great, but we haven't started flying yet. The bulk of your training costs are going to be spent on the actual flight training done in the aircraft. And this is where things get expensive fairly quickly. The two main costs, aircraft hourly rental and instructor hourly charges. Now, the bare minimum flight hour requirements for the private license in the US is 40. In Canada, the minimum is 45, and this may differ depending on what country you do your training. But this is almost an insignificant number, because unless you are an ace or a grandchild to the Red Baron, the legendary pilot from World War I, chances are you will require a bit more flight training time than the bare minimum. For example, it took me 67.3 hours on the dot of flight time to get my license. And when I recently surveyed several other flight schools, they suggested that on average, a student should expect to get their license in 55 to 70 hours of flight time on average. And that's not to say you can't finish the license at the 40-hour minimum mark. However, we want to play it on the safe side and just assume the industry average of 55 to 70 hours. Going back to the minimum 40 flight hours required, 20 must be dual with an instructor and at least 10 must be solo. That means flying by yourself, and you still need an additional 10 hours of training and practice just to meet the minimum total hours of 40. So if we consider this, we can allocate the hours accordingly in a more realistic manner. We can estimate a required 30 to 40 hours of dual instruction time and roughly 25 to 35 hours of solo flight time. This is important for cost estimation because dual instruction time costs more than solo time. Simply put, solo time you aren't paying for an instructor by the hour to fly with you. But how much does the flight training cost? One of the most common aircraft used for flight training is the Cessna 172. You've probably heard of it. And trust me, even to this day, I still love flying a 172 once in a while. A 172's rental rate varies depending on the flight school, the condition of the aircraft, and what the aircraft has for avionics and equipment. Nowadays, I find I can rent a 172 usually between $120 and $160 per hour. So let's just say an average price of $145 per flight hour is reasonable. There are other types of aircraft used for training, but you can expect similar prices for a four-seat piston airplane used for training. And that is not a Cessna 172, that is actually a Cessna Conquest 425. A lot of people didn't realize, but Cessna did build a twin turboprop back in the day, and that is it. It's actually one of the planes that I fly. Then there's the instructor cost. Typically, an instructor will cost around $60 per hour. So dual instruction time, meaning you're paying for the instructor while you're renting the airplane, will be slightly more expensive. And that's because you're paying for the airplane plus the instructor. Now, a lot of schools will have what's called dual time or a dual rate, where they include the instructor in the rate of the aircraft. So basically take $60, add it on top of the rental rate of $145 for the aircraft, and that would be your dual rate. Now, if we do some simple calculations, considering the realistic hours we plan to spend in the aircraft, both dual and solo time, then we can come up with some interesting numbers. Dual time should cost around $6,000 up to about $8,000. Solo time should cost around $3,600 up to just over $5,000. Of course, this is assuming that we're gonna spend more training time in the aircraft than the bare minimum of 40 hours. It's actually based off of what most flight schools said it took for their students to get their private license. After that comes the practical flight test done in the airplane. An examiner may cost anywhere from $200 to $400 for a typical private pilot flight test. Don't forget though, you must also rent an airplane for the test, so budget another $300 conservatively for that as well. This leaves us with a total flight time training cost of almost $10,000 on the low end, up to almost $14,000 on the high end. Just for comparison's sake, if you manage to ace everything during your flight training and get your test done by the minimum 40 hours required, it would cost you still an approximately $7,000 for the flight portion. A significant difference from what many flight schools report as the average cost for their students. Remember, I spent 67.3 hours of flight training in the airplane, so I found that I fell right into the average reported range of 55 to 70 hours. Also, take note that if an aircraft rental rate seems very low, it may be because the flight school charges a dry rate. This means that the fuel is an additional cost. It's rare that you see that. Most places charge what's called a wet rental rate, and that includes the fuel in the rental price. Lastly, there are some costs that often get overlooked. The first being headset purchase. You're going to need a headset. Now, some schools will let you rent a headset, or they may even just include it in the rental rate. However, eventually you're going to want to buy your own. So from $200 up to, and this is going to sound crazy, $1,200 for a headset. Now, I'm not the type of person that will spend $1,200 for a headset necessarily, unless, you know, I really want to treat myself, but a less expensive headset in the $200 to $400 range will do you just fine. Another cost to consider is upgrading your kneeboard, as well as buying some other flight tools such as flashlights, calculators. Budget around $100 to $400 for these simple upgrades. And $400 might seem expensive. You don't necessarily have to spend that much, but maybe upgrading your kneeboard to one of the ones that folds out or that can hold an iPad might be a good investment. Then there's also the cost of getting to and from the airport. Don't forget to consider this, because if the airport is, you know, 30 miles away, then yeah, you may want to add that in and consider, what does it cost you to get to and from the airport? And then there is the cost for a tablet or an iPad. Now, it may sound crazy, like, why do I have to buy an iPad to do flight training? Well, having an iPad in the cockpit is very, very common and very useful. I use my iPad for charts, for maps, for all sorts of flight planning tools, as well as calculators. It is one of the most useful things you can have in the cockpit. Now, the last cost you need to consider is time, the opportunity cost, and that is priceless. As I think we will all learn eventually, time is the most precious thing we have. So if you can't allocate the time required to focus on your training, then it will likely cost you more dollars in the end, because you will constantly have to be refreshing yourself and going back to relearn parts of your training that you've already done. I recommend starting your training when you feel you are ready and able to commit. That means don't start your training if you have 1,001 things going on, or you're overly stressed or financially in a really tight situation. And especially don't start flight training if you don't have a passion for it. If you're passionate about flying, then you'll willingly put in the hours and time it takes to make sure you learn everything you can. It is perhaps the number one driver for flight training success. So what does this bring us to in the end for costs? Well, plug this into my calculator here, and we end up with approximately $11,000 on the low end, up to almost $16,000 on the high end. But of course, we haven't added in the additional costs that we just talked about, so you'll want to consider that as well. Now, like I said earlier in the video, I was going to reveal to you how much it cost me when I got my private license, $11,100, give or take a few. Now, this was back in 2006, when renting an airplane was quite a bit cheaper. However, if I had done my training today, I would have been on par with the average student today. Although at the time of my training, I was actually too young to have my driver's license. So if I factored in my parents' hourly rate to drive me to and from the airport, I'd probably be way over budget. So thanks, Mom and Dad, for the support. And that brings me to my last point. Don't aim necessarily for the cheapest flight training possible. Flight training costs can range significantly, but it mostly depends on you and how efficient you are at your training. All of the things you should consider when choosing the right flight school are topics for another video, but I can tell with absolute certainty that although the costs of flight training are an important consideration, they are second to good instruction and quality training. Don't forget to subscribe, give this video a like. The support is greatly appreciated and it helps me keep making videos like this one. If you are a pilot and would love to share how much it costs you for your flight training, put it in the comment section below. If you have any questions or just want to tell me what your favorite airplane is, let me know in the comments as well. And as always, happy and safe flying.